Atomic model. I'm your chemistry teacher, Samyuktas. Today's objectives are describe postulates of Bohr atomic model. We also draw Bohr atomic model for the atoms indicating the location of electrons, protons, and neutrons. Niels Bohr, Danish physicist, who joined Rutherford in 1912 for his research work. In 1913, Bohr presented his atomic model based upon quantum theory. He won Nobel Prize in 1922 for the physics for his work on the structure of an atom. Bohr proposed his quantized shell model of the atom to explain how electrons can have stable orbit around the nucleus. The energy of an electron depends on the size of the orbit and is lower for the smaller orbital. Radiation can occur only when the electron jumps from one orbit to another orbit. Observe this diagram. At the center, all the mass concentrated over there, proton and neutron. Therefore, nucleus having positive nature due to the presence of proton. Around the nucleus, we observe shell. There are various number of shell, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, which indicate KLM and so on. When electron revolve in the nucleus, around the nucleus, in a specific path, it do not radiate any energy. But if it jumps from lower to higher energy level, it absorb energy. And when it will back, it release or emit energy. Postulates of Bohr atomic model. Number one, electron revolve around the nucleus in a fixed circular path, termed orbits or shells. Each orbit has a fixed energy, so each orbit is also called energy level. Number two, the energy of the electron in an orbit is proportional to its distance from the nucleus. The farther the electron is from the nucleus, the more energy it has. Look at the diagram. At the center, nucleus, and around the nucleus, we observe number of shells. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on, which name as KLMN and so on. The nearest the nucleus, shell having lower energy. The far from the nucleus, the shell having high energy. First shell, for example, E1, having low energy level shell, and second shell, E2, having high energy level. The energy level are represented by an integer, that is 1, 2, 3 whole number, known as a quantum number. This range of quantum number starts from nucleus side with n is equal to 1 having the lowest energy level. The electron revolve only in those orbits for which the angular momentum of the electron is an integral multiple of h by 2 pi. First shell, the distance between nucleus and the first shell is h upon 2 pi. And second is the integral of multiple of this value, and so on. Where h is the Planck's constant, its value is 6.626 into 10 to the power 34 joules per second. Observe this diagram. Number one shell, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Light is absorbed when an electron jumps to a higher energy orbit and emitted when an electron falls into a lower energy orbit. Electron present in a particular orbit does not radiate energy. Got it? If any electron revolve in a fixed circular path or orbit or energy level, it do not radiate energy. But if electron absorb energy, it becomes the higher state and jump from lower to higher energy level. When it back, it will be radiate energy or emit energy. The energy of the light emitted exactly equal to the difference between the energies of the orbits. Delta is equal to E2 minus E1. E2 is the high energy level and E1 is the lower energy level. Observe this diagram. First shell, second shell, third shell. If any electron jump from the first shell to the second shell, it absorbs energy. When it will back, it emit energy. And this difference will be equal to the difference in the energy level, where delta is the energy difference between any two orbits with energies E1 and E2. Now, how we can draw Bohr's model for the atom and how we can indicate the location of electrons, protons and neutrons in Bohr model. According to the Bohr model, energy level with maximum accommodation of electron, first shell K is equal to 2, second shell L is equal to 8, M third shell maximum accommodation is 8, fourth N shell maximum accommodation is 18, fifth shell O maximum accommodation is 18, sixth shell P and Q maximum accommodation is 32, but seventh shell is still incomplete, seventh field is still incomplete, its maximum capacity 23. Now example number 1, we are going to draw Bohr atomic model for carbon atom. Atomic number 6, mass number 12. Electron 6, proton 6, neutron 6. Electronic configuration is K is equal to 2, L is equal to 4. Inside the nucleus, we present a proton or neutron. In first shell, we indicate 2 electrons and remaining 4 will be accommodated in second shell. Therefore, electronic configuration is K is equal to 2, L is equal to 4. Example number 2, silicon, atomic number 14, mass number 28. Mass number minus atomic number, we obtain the number of neutron. Therefore, electron is equal to 14, proton is equal to 14, neutron is equal to 14, 28 minus 14. Electronic configuration, K will be 2, L will be 8, and M will be 4. Accommodation of electron. We draw 2 electron in the K shell, 8 electron in the S shell, and remaining 4 electron in the M shell. Example number 2. Example number 3. Chlorine. Atomic number 17. Mass number 35. Mass number minus atomic number. We obtain number of neutrons. Electron 17. Proton 17. Neutron 35 minus 17. 18. Electronic configuration, K is equal to 2, L is equal to 8, M is equal to 7. Number of proton and neutron will be addressed inside the nucleus. In first shell, we represent 2 electron, accommodate 2 electron. In second shell, we mention 8 electron and remaining 7 will be accommodated in shell, third shell, that is M shell. If you have any question or queries, please message me. Thank you.